Hey guys, this is David Kwan, here to talk about the movie The High Cost of Living. And it's a movie I stumbled into. It's not a movie I intentionally searched for. It's not a movie I knew anything about. But I stumbled into it because I was browsing on Netflix. I was browsing about Scrubs, and I love Scrubs, TV show that I just ended up watching all episodes of, and I loved watching it, except for season 9, the last season of Scrubs, which just not exist at all. But at the very bottom of a Netflix page about a movie, you can notice all the movies that are... It says movies like Scrubs or shows like Scrubs. And on there, it was The High Cost of Living. Honestly, it's a weird thing that this is on there. The only reason it would be on there is because it shares the same actor, Zach Braff, who is, you know, the main actor in Scrubs, one of the starring actors in Scrubs, is a starring actor in The High Cost of Living. That's, as far as similarity goes, that's it. This movie, if it wasn't for Zach Braff as an actor, this movie does not belong on that list of movies like Scrub. Scrub is a comedy. It's about, like, you know, hospital life as a resident. The High Cost of Living is like an indie film. And with dark overtones, it's not a comedy. It's like the opposite of comedy, except it doesn't make you cry. It just makes you really feel stuff. It's morbid. It's dark. It has that indie film feeling. You know, every indie film is just like has that drab kind of authentic feel to it that this film does. And I think it's really interesting that this film is set in Montreal, Canada. I don't know, there must be a whole bunch of films set in that location, but me personally, I haven't watched too many films set in this particular location. So I thought that was really interesting. That's what made me especially immersed into this story. And it feels super authentic because a lot of the characters, especially the starring female character who is I believe the actress name is Isabel Blaise. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Isabel Bly or Blay. And she speaks French, but obviously with Jack Braff, who is acting as portraying the character Henry, you know, they speak English between each other. But there's French involved, they speak French, there's English subtitles when you're speaking French. It feels really authentic, and I enjoyed it for that. It really immerses me into the whole story. It's morbid and dark, even from the get-go. Even when there's no plot, it has a dark undertone. Particularly because it does follow the life of Henry, who, you know, with actor Jack Braff is Henry. And Henry is a drug dealer, not like a gang drug dealer. He doesn't sell heroin or marijuana or cocaine or, you know, those kind of substances. He does sell prescription or like medicine like codeine or oxycodone, kind of those pills. The stuff that you would find in hospital is what he gets his hands on and sells to different people that he's pretty close with. The way the movie portrays this character, he's just kind of like, he's just living from moment to moment to moment without a foot in anywhere. He is settling in this place. It's like a building that is used by these Chinese people who has like a Chinese restaurant. And I guess he's either in the basement floor or like this one of the, I think it's like the second floor actually, second floor of that building, which is a Chinese restaurant. And he's close with the owners of that restaurant, the Chinese people that own the land. It follows him as he's drug dealing, but it also follows Natalie, who is the main female character. And Natalie, before she meets Henry, kind of has a normal, relatively speaking, normal life. She's pregnant, is expecting to give birth to a kid. She has a loving husband, although the marriage is not a perfect marriage. The husband is always busy, has always got to do something for his company. And so that's one of the tension between the two. There is some kind of tension between Natalie and her husband. And it just falls apart once Henry becomes involved in the picture. So seeing how that happens is pretty amazing. The chemistry between Henry and Natalie, I think, is is a well done job. Like the acting skills between the two when the two are together, I think was awesome. It really did immerse me into this kind of story and it felt super authentic. I think one reason why we love indie films is because they have this tendency to make it feel like the whole experience is authentic and just hits home. You know, the plot in general is a pretty basic one. It's expected what's going to happen, but like it wasn't really the plot that, you know, that got me in here. You know, the plot is Natalie has a miscarriage because Henry is driving one night to deliver his drugs, and he ends up getting lost, and on the way, he hits Natalie with the car, and Natalie does have a car accident, and he just does a hit and run. And so Henry is, because he has a guilty conscience, he checks up on Natalie and finds out that she had a miscarriage, and that's the reason why, that's like the boiling point. And Natalie's marriage with her husband just falls apart, and Natalie and Henry end up living together. And, you know, from then on, like, you can expect, like, the tension is that Henry wants to tell Natalie the truth about what happened with her miscarriage, but can't bring himself to do it. But you know, with this plot, you know it's going to happen at some point. And that point is pretty near the end. And you just know it's going to, like, it's weird how the movie kind of makes you kind of twist your emotions in a way. Because I was thinking, like, oh man, like, what will be Natalie's reaction to that? You know Natalie's gonna react, is not gonna react well. But there's always a doubt, like, I feel like Natalie will be forgiving. You know, that kind of tension between the two characters, the chemistry that they have, that's what made me super immersed into this film. It does hit home in a lot of ways. The subject matter is not particularly, like, super deep, but it does make you feel the grief of somebody who's gone, you know, undergone a miscarriage and must carry that, the remnant, the scar of that, even physically, because they don't remove the dead baby inside her stomach until way later. And the emotional toil that all the characters go through in this video is quite something. It's definitely not a comedy. It's not something that I would just enjoy with eating. It's not a popcorn flick. You know, but it is a serious film. It's not going to make you cry, but it does make me feel and think a lot. And I thought that was quite an interesting film to watch because of that. So yeah, those are my thoughts on the movie, The High Cost of Living. I do have to hand off to, you know, the actors here, especially Jack Braff. I've always seen him in Scrubs. He has this comedic role. So seeing him this like super serious kind of, he doesn't talk very much, very introverted, yet this kind of undercover lifestyle that he has, or not undercover, but underground lifestyle that he has. Pretty interesting, so.